Power Trip on the Fan.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to video number 29.
I'm going to perform oral sex on you. Oh, she's going to be a big girl. Would you be quiet, Rosie?
I'm Bill Zimper.
Scott Stapp is this summer's rock and roll savior.
Listen up. The ratings just came this month. We are number one. We just grabbed every key demographic.
Super duper.
That's nice. Way to go. Neato, gang.
Yes.
Boy, that is good news.
It is the 12th day of January, 2020. A little chilly out there. But it's going to be a little chillier throughout the day. You know, bundle up. It's Friday. How you feeling? Let's go. My name is Chris Hockey. Thanks for tuning in to the Power Trip Morning Show on a Friday. You know, the initials game is coming up. Special guests galore. Marnie, my main man, Mark Parrish, and more. So let's get her started. Here's Norm MacDonald back in the old days. Some comedy on a Friday on the Power Trip Morning Show. I hope you got a great weekend planned. I hope you got a warm weekend planned. Regardless, I hope you're smiling. Come on in. I'm glad you're here.
Hey, but you know, it's a great show. Star Search. You ever watch that show? That is an excellent show. Excellent. I tell you what the best thing about Star Search is, you get to see the stars of tomorrow today. You don't have to wait an extra day. My favorite things on Star Search is the junior dancers. Those are my favorite, you know? I love those junior dancers because I like how Ed introduces them. You know, it's always like, hot property! Too cute for you! The funny thing about the junior dancers is it's not like if they win, they're going to go on to become junior dancers. Like, there's no place in show business for that, you know? That's not like you're ever hanging out. Hey, honey, what do you want to do tonight? Go see a movie or something? Or maybe grab a beer down at a bar or something? Hey, I know a good thing. Hey, why don't we go to that new joint they got down on Main Street there? That's a good club. They got, 6-year-olds dancing. Yeah, I understand Hot Property's going to be there tonight. They're good. Yeah, that's right, little children.
Show it is Friday, January 12th. Full crew in effect. I'm Corey Cole. That's Chris Hockey. There's Sauce. There's Zachary Halverson. And it's Friday, which means the gentleman, John Kriesel, is in the building. Hi, John.
What's up, friends?
Good morning, gentlemen.
Bitchin'.
Yeah, hi, John. Bitchin'.
Good to see you.
It's colder than balls.
Yeah, there's balls that are warmer than this.
Yeah, you just mentioned in the open. Hope you have a find a warm weekend somewhere. It ain't here, right? Get out of town.
Yeah, get the hell out of here.
Go to San Diego with Kriesel.
Yeah, I mean,
Lieber he goes spot. Every 2 weeks. It's Lieber spot, exactly.
In Jamaica that, next week.
Oh, Lieber spot.
Jamaican me horny.
Getting paid to go there for a speaking engagement.
Oh my God. Are you staying at the Mucklucks?
No, it's Royalton Negril.
Dude, that's Lieber's spot.
Yeah.
He loves it there.
Yeah, great. I've heard. Great steaks and burgers.
Can't wait to tell everybody that Lieber likes it there.
Oh, great. Well, otherwise I wouldn't be impressed that you're going.
Right, exactly.
Got it.
I'm only half a man.
Have you been to Jamaica before?
No, this will be my first time.
Sweet. Just you, or are you bringing the whole fam?
Nope, just me.
Just
because it's a quick in and out.
Oh.
It's 2 nights, but I get in like Tuesday evening.
Tie down.
Speak Wednesday morning.
Yeah, tie down.
I'm done at like 11. There's book signing, meet and greet, and then I have freedom, so I'm going to just roam the resort.
Yeah,
they have some spicy food I saw at one of their restaurants.
All inclusive?
Yes, sir.
Oh hell yeah!
Oh yeah.
Okay. Where are you flying into?
Montego Bay.
Okay.
So it's like hour and a half ride. So I'm going to get their
great
money's worth
point, Hawk.
On the liquor
great
for sure.
Good luck with that.
I always complain about the quality of an all-inclusive, but I would argue if you give me
food X, but it's 70% as good as it normally is. Mm-hmm. But just give me the freedom in my mind to know I can have as much as I want.
Yeah.
I'll take the downgrade in quality for the absolute freedom.
Yeah. You want to know else?
Give me three more of those. But they're not even good. I don't care.
Yeah.
I want to enjoy three more of them.
Do you know what you want to know what else?
What?
If it's all inclusive, I'm probably going to throw it up anyway.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Naked, right?
Because you're having rail tequila.
Oh, I'm getting railed?
Yeah. You're getting railed with rail tequila, and it's coming up anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, can't, yeah.
God, tequila or margaritas at an all inclusive is the best.
Blue Hawaiian,
the
baby.
The best.
Yeah, you did. Remember when I did that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is this is an all timer right here, Chris.
I know, man.
Right here.
Yeah. This is going to be you, circa Wednesday night.
Yep.
Balls out.
Your balls
are... Well, no,
I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you. You ripped your shorts.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. There we go. Then, sure.
During your speech.
Oh, my goodness.
That's what the crowd said. Yeah. The women are going to be as stunned as that lady was in the rabbits.
Yeah. JohnKriesel.com, by the way.
Yeah, that'll be a real speech.
You want to see those nuts?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Where are you speaking, in like a theater or something? Like, what do they got down there?
They have a ballroom because it's a company's.
Oh, sure.
Hey, listen, John, every room's a ballroom.
Yeah. Right. True. I suppose if I'm in there, right?
Yeah, right. It's
like cold as balls room up here.
Yeah, tie
this
down.
This weekend.
Yeah, somebody tie down.
It
down.
Would you tie it down, please?
Tie it down.
Yes, yes, yes. Funny.
Yeah. That'd be fun, man.
Mm-hmm.
It is crazy that John Stamos is in the Beach Boys.
Yeah.
Right.
Apparently, he's a pretty damn good drummer.
It would like, what if you woke up and just, hey, did you hear David Schwimmer joined Megadeth?
Brilliant. That's funny.
Honestly, I think we're overlooking the fact that Stamos is a Beach Boy.
Well, I mean, his work and Jesse and the Rippers was certainly
his precursor,
right?
Yeah.
And he worked his way up. Rippers.
If I had time right now, I'd take a random Megadeth song and put Pivot.
Brilliant. Brilliant.
Yeah, that's a Friends fan right there.
Yeah.
Pivot. Pivot.
Hey, you know what I just found out?
Hmm.
Mike Kaplan, the comedian's at Acme tonight.
That dude's hilarious.
He's so good, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, was it Cy? I forget who it was. It probably was Cy Amundsen. I think it was Cy. Somebody told me, it must have been pre-pandemic even.
Gangnam Style?
No, it must have been before the pandemic. So maybe like 4 years ago. Like, go see Mike Kaplan. He's hilarious. But he's like smarter than the room. So sometimes it doesn't hit.
Yeah.
And that is 100% correct. I could see he's so clever that I think people, if you're not paying attention, if you're just there to drink and... His jokes are so layered. I was kind of blown away. The dude's kind of a genius.
Have you seen him live?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Is that what you just said?
Did your wife talk the whole time?
I don't think she went.
Oh.
Or did she? Because if she did, she definitely would have talked the whole time.
Yeah, that's... Remember, they were taking pictures for the holiday card.
Oh. So Corey wasn't there.
Did they at least put not pictured?
Nope.
No.
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 Because that would have been funny.
We're going to show up to your funeral. There's not going to be any pictures of you on the board.
I remember.
My wife's going to say, I couldn't find a good picture of it.
It'll be a picture of Angie with two thumbs up.
When was this taken?
Up what?
Yesterday?
Yeah. When she was picking out your casket. Yes! Yeah. Oh, God, this song ripped.
Yeah, I played it again.
Yeah, why not?
Why not, man? It's cold outside.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're getting a snowstorm, Hawk. Your favorite kind.
I wish we were getting a bigger one.
Yeah.
We're getting kind of
like in Chicago.
Like just below us.
Chicago's going to get killed.
Oh, yeah. Chicago's getting big.
Football games are going to get weird this weekend.
They're going to suck.
See, how about the weather in Kansas City?
Why didn't we talk to Ben, by the way? Ben's all pumped up about the weather in Kansas City. Why didn't we talk to him about it? Because he's the only one on my side. I like it.
No, I think most people are on your side.
Oh, well, in this room.
I don't talk to you
guys. What the hell do I know? I think you guys are the whole world.
Oh,
what the hell do I know?
That's kind of you.
That's the one I don't get to watch.
I didn't mean
in a good way. So I'll be at a birthday party. My cousin's 50th. Happy birthday, Misty. Yeah, so I will miss.
Hawk has slept with a
So Misty. She better know how much I love her, because I don't miss. Yeah. I mean, there's not many people that I would miss a playoff football game, even a non-Vikings one for. So
yeah.
But I'm excited. Super wild card weekend.
I'm proud of you.
Bangs.
I'm proud of you for doing that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
that's you. A big move.
It is a big move.
You're all grown up.
I am starting to grow up.
Yeah.
Yeah. I just wish I could bet on him. That's all.
You can.
And not with you guys. I mean, you know, just actually bet on
him. You can. I do it all the time.
He does it all the time.
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah. You know what I mean. Like legally or at a sports book.
This isn't illegal.
Gray area.
It's gray area.
It's frowned upon, but not punishable by death.
Yeah, right. Man.
I don't think... like doing things that are frowned upon.
Like masturbating on a plane? Thanks, Bin Laden.
Wow.
Yeah, great bit.
What's that been?
Oh, that's Hangover.
Hangover.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. God, that movie is so good.
It holds up nonstop. Oh, yes.
It's so good.
The first one is super good.
It's, that's become one of those movies that...
You look like a fat Sasquatch.
I'm sorry, I'm just talking.
Not you. Isn't that what he says to him?
Yeah.
The outtakes are so good.
So good. That's one of those movies that I see on television edited so often. When I get to see it unedited, I'm like, damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Damn. Although.
It gets greasy.
Although.
Yeah, that movie is greater than the sun.
Yeah, so's this song.
Are you greater than the sun?
First thing I heard when I was pulling out of the garage today, and I was like...
I heard it six times this morning.
Yeah. I sometimes play it back to back.
It's going to be a good day. You play it back to back with who?
Tommy.
Yeah, he doesn't like that.
That checks out.
No, I don't
better he's be front to front. Yeah. He wants to play Tommy Sticks.
Hey, quit looking over here, pal. I have a nice set of fakies for him.
So Mr. Z's going to be calling in about 6:20.
Yep.
Marnie later. Parrish later. Our buddy Alan Horton, who we haven't seen in a long time, the Wolves play-by-play guy, is making his initials game debut, and he hasn't been on the show in, 10 years?
I can't even remember if
I don't think he's been on the show since I've been on this show.
Oh, really?
I don't remember. I mean, maybe I was gone, but when did they flip to CCO?
Ooh, that's a good question.
I bet he's...
08, 09?
When it found out that they weren't coming back... Somebody told me, I board up the last Wolves game on the Fan. Someone told me to never play any liners during the game. Just let it, you know, like, the Fan. I was told not to do any of that.
Just let it die.
Basically, yeah.
Once we knew it was gone?
Yeah, yeah.
I like that. Sabotage it on the way out.
Yeah.
Just right, pulling the plug, pulling the life support.
Yeah. Meat sauce it on the way out.
Yeah.
Don't even tell the listeners what they're listening to. They won't figure it out.
No. The other side of that is, who cares?
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. There's nobody at home going, but what station is this?
Correct. Correct. Yeah.
I know I'm listening to the Timberwolves.
No legal ID.
I have a book I need to write down stuff in.
I'm keeping score.
It's been an hour.
There's a police officer going, I haven't heard on legal ID.
Yeah, I'm on my way there.
It's
you.
I'm about to kick somebody's ass.
Sauce is being drugged out in handcuffs.
Yeah.
Sir.
I'm going to have to kick somebody's ass.
Speaking of legal IDs, if I don't hear them run that emergency alert system test in the next 2 hours.
Yeah, I'm going to shoot someone.
Either way, Alan Horton's such a good dude.
Yeah, the best.
And he'll be here. And I have no idea if he's going to be good at initials or not. I don't know if Marnie told me whether or not she believes that he is going to be good.
I think she said he's good at it.
She believes in life after love.
She does. Great point.
What a week for Marin. She was the play-by-play voice in Orlando a couple days ago. Then she was on Craig Kilborn's podcast. Now she's on this show. What a week for her.
Yeah,
so unfortunate.
In that order. Crescendo to the end.
Yeah, putting on Backsplash in her new kitchen. Everything's happening.
Go ahead.
Can't get into your email?
No. I just read an article.
Oh, no.
Okay. This is on my news source. The real news. As far as I know, what the hell do I know? I wasn't there. A report claims ESPN concocted an Emmy scheme.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Using fake names to get awards for its top talent. The Athletic says the Sports Network got the awards that were submitted with fake names, then re-engraved them and gave the statuettes to their on-air personalities. Apparently, there was an ineligibility issue involving the talent. Big stars, including Herb Street, Fowler, Desmond Howard, Samantha Ponder, were among those who got fake Emmys. ESPN has apologized and said, we're a bunch of dumbasses. What the hell is that? That's a real news story.
Yep. And it's not like that's just some random one-off network in Utah or something. This is ESPN.
And it went
Who greenlighted
for
that?
Years.
Yeah, and the names, some of the names they used were Dirk Howard and Stephen Ponder.
And Kirk Henry.
Yeah, Kirk Henry.
I'm starting to wonder if this Nobel Prize I got for my heart is not real.
Oh, no.
Brilliant.
What the hell would they do that for? Who thinks? What the hell?
This AVN award I got, it's not real?
Oh, no, that's real. That's John. Real. John, yeah, that's real. Don't throw that out.
By the way.
Best adult disabled star of 2023?
Seriously, that's the weirdest thing. Who cares enough?
Amputee porn, you mean? Emmys?
No, but I'm making notes.
But isn't it twofold? It's twofold. It's you can't believe they did that. That's number one, right?
Yeah, that's how you won the award.
I'm more blown away by that. This is even possible. How do you even apply? Fake names? Like how did they win?
Yeah, the Emmy people. How did they pick these fake people?
Right. I'm so confused.
What book of work did they send and say here is?
Man,
what they should be judged on.
Niles Chicago sounds just like Kirk Herbstreit.
Right, these sound like porn names.
Yeah, correct. How did Rod Boulder do?
Weird, man. God,
Niles Chicago is a sweet name.
Yeah.
Well, it could be yours.
I don't know a guy's named Niles. Except for the guy from
Great Theater. Song.
Ah, great song, dude.
The Beach Boys. The Beach Boys.
They slap some butts. Yeah.
All right.
They slap some butts.
You think they threw the boots to Rhonda?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
he helped him get his schlong out of his pants.
That's what
the song is about.
Which one? Oh, brilliant. Did help one me, of them Rhonda. Have a huge schlong?
I'm sure they all did.
Who's the main guy?
Jerry Russell.
That's why they carried surfboards, was to cover up the hog.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Yeah, they had a separate surfboard for the dog.
They're such a great band.
Yes, they are.
And what's his face wrote all of it, right, Hard?
Stamos?
Yeah.
All right, more of the Power Trip Morning Show Brian, after this. On the band.
What's Brian's last name? Come on, help me out. Brian from the Beach Boys.
Wilson?
Brian Wilson, thank you.
The Fan.
Welcome, everybody. The Power Trip Morning Show. It's 5:51. Good morning to you. And wouldn't it be nice to live together in the kind it's Friday. The Kriesel is here.
Heck yeah.
Wouldn't it be nice?
Gord, did the Beach Boys do anything for you?
Yeah, they come over and cut his grass.
Oh, that's hot ass.
No, that's hot ass Randy, right.
He's your Beach Boy.
I like that you shorten it to hot ass.
Yeah, I saw him yesterday.
How's he doing?
How's he's that great. Ass of his?
Great dude.
Yeah.
Did he talk about lizard people?
No, he did talk about
shadow aliens?
Yeah, shadow aliens and the moon base.
Oh, the moon base.
The invisible moon
base. He didn't talk about the 11-foot aliens they have video of? The hikers got?
No, we told him he couldn't talk about that on the text chain anymore.
Well, tell Randy this. According to NASA, we will not be walking on the moon again now until 2026.
What about the sun?
Nope.
Son of a bitch.
It was supposed to happen next year, but NASA pushed it back for safety reasons. So, moonwalking 2026.
Oh, no. Does Michael Jackson know?
No, he's no longer with us.
So, no moonwalking?
No.
Oh, this song wails.
Thanks. Sorry, Sting. You don't get to walk on the moon.
No. Poor Sting.
Isn't there a song called Walking on the Sun?
It's Smash Mouth.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We have to have that in the
song. That was before All-Star. That was their first big hit, Walking on the Sun.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, here it is.
You ever see them?
No.
I loved this one.
This song was
a ripper.
Yeah.
It's a good tune.
All-Star was a gigantic hit, but that was the defining line. Everybody's like, nah, we're done with Smash Mouth. This was played on every alt station in the country for a couple of years. This was a big hit.
I think this was about when I got my driver's license.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, that's...
You were rolling.
As Chloe would say, that's back, way back in the old times.
Yep. Yeah, that is the old times.
Isn't he dead?
Yeah, he died this year.
Oh, geez.
23.
Yeah.
What was it?
I can't remember. But he, yeah, he was, I think he was my age. He wasn't very old, man.
Man.
Yeah.
If
you got the goods, they'll come and buy it just to stay in the click.
So act now, supplies are running out. I mean, there's a lot of mail. This song, I just don't like the rest of their stuff.
There's a lot of mailbox money in these Red Hogs.
Yeah, who cares?
I feel like, though, once they got a lot more mainstream, this song kind of disappeared.
Yeah.
It was all the
softer stuff, cheesy stuff, yeah.
And then they did.
Oh, God.
Yeah, they did this for Shrek, right?
Yeah.
But isn't this some...
The Monkees.
People will rip bands like that, but how do you say no to the money?
Oh, you can't. No. It's not their fault.
No.
Why wouldn't you do it?
Okay,
I think Neil Diamond wrote this song.
So, did they make any money off of it?
If they put it on a record and their record sold, the answer is yes.
Okay.
But from this song itself, no.
This probably was back when you had to buy records, right?
Oh, sure.
When was...
Oh,
Shrek was like early 2000s.
Oh,
it was pre-iTunes,
01?
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's all blending together now.
Back in the old times?
Back in the old times.
Shrek 1 was... 01, yeah.
I'm a Believer is a song written by Neil Diamond. Yeah.
So...
1966.
When he writes it, and I know it's probably all different, there's not like a locked-in percentage, but generally... What would Neil Diamond get? What percentage of sales of this song? Like, if I bought this song right now, would he get like half?
You get there. See, there. The proceeds from the sale of a song are divided in a lot of different ways. But you got the writer's portion and the
label, right?
What do you call that? So the producer's portion. So it all depends on what the percentages of his record deal were at the time.
Okay.
But regardless, he wrote the song, and no matter who records it, whether it was the Monkees originally or this version on the Shrek soundtrack, that's just going right into his bank account.
God, it's good being Neil Diamond.
Yeah, put it on the pile. Oh, will you play Cracklin' Rosie? We haven't heard that in a while.
Yeah, somebody brought that up the other day.
I love that song.
I know you do.
Oh. And then
I saw the... I don't know why I sounded condescending.
It sounded like we know. Shut up.
Oh,
so good. I love this
song. You know what
song.
This song is about?
Wine. Mm-hmm.
Smoke and crack.
What?
It's about that he couldn't find a gal to go to a dance.
And smoke crack.
Bought a bottle of wine called Cracklin' Rosie.
Yeah, royalties are generated are typically split 50-50 between the songwriter and the publisher.
Jeez.
In perpetuity. That's the word I was trying to think of. Perpetuity.
And that, That song is sold a few times.
Oh, yeah.
And as Hawk always says, a lot of these songs were sold back when records were the
hit.
Hold
on, he's getting sexy. Here he goes.
Oh, I love my rosy child.
It's so good. I know you hate it.
No, I believe it was Kurt Cobain that once said, I wish I was like you, easily amused. Because you love this so much.
I love this song.
And it makes you laugh all the time.
Yeah.
And that's awesome. This is the best.
It's so good.
Play with it now. Play it now.
That's Rosie's version. Now, here's the thing about Neil Diamond. That song, Wales. Sweet Caroline is pure garbage.
Oh,
I'm so tired of that song.
Everybody's tired of it, but that's a 10 times better song than Cracklin' Rosie.
Oh, damn it.
Way better. No. It's just like, as we always say on the show, it's crispy.
Yeah, it's not.
It's burnt into the ground.
That's not the song's fault.
Yeah.
Way better song.
Terrible.
This gets the people going.
Are you kidding me?
It sure does.
It's a slam dunk.
I like seeing people happy,
me
so
too.
I know, but it's just over and over.
But then I know it's
over.
It's like my material.
Strong.
It's the same thing over and over again. Well, thank you, Hawk.
this damn song.
Is this the MASH theme?
This is I Am. Brilliant. It does sound like another
song. It does. The remix of it, yeah.
This is the MASH.
I do think that I like this song a lot.
Oh, yeah, this song.
There's one line in this song that I'm like, you try harder, Neil.
And the feeling is laid back.
And I wrote, I love my country.
I love that you always followed up with that.
But you know, keep thinking about.
Because this is all sweet. You're in the mood with him, right? You know he's drinking some cognac.
Yeah. Do you think Neil had a giant schlong?
I think he did once or twice, probably. But he never told anybody about it.
We are 29 minutes into the show, and already Paul has asked, do the Beach Boys all have giant schlongs? And do you think Neil Diamond has a giant schlong?
Tommy's ruining him.
Yeah.
So you're with him, right? You're thinking, this guy means what he says. But I'm going to tell you the one line that I think is interesting. He's, you know, he's making a comment that he exists. I'm me, man. I'm here. But he's by himself. Nobody's listening, right? But he still feels like, I'm there. I'm me. I got this. What?
Even the chair.
He says, I said, to no one there, and no one heard, not even the chair.
Because the chair is even tired of here.
Yeah, he's tired of
sitting. Look, the timeline might not make sense, but is it possible he wrote this from the perspective of Pee Wee Herman? And Cherry could talk.
Okay.
Great. And if even Cherry was like, I don't get you.
Yeah.
You're not seen.
If the chair looked at him and went, what?
What if the chair looked at him and said, shut up. Nobody cares what you have to say.
Now, again, you want to talk about lazy writing, right? The writers of Pee-wee's Playhouse, it's, what are we going to name this chair?
Yeah. And then became one. I heard
Cherry.
Dude, that's funny you bring that up. I was listening to something about comedy. I don't remember what it was, but they were talking about how brilliant it was that Pee-wee Herman took the idea that things could become sentient that cartoons use and brought it to reality television, yeah. And brought it to reality in a way that nobody had before and made a big deal out of how that was kind of groundbreaking.
I didn't know that at the time.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, yeah.
I loved it when I was a kid, right? Hey, there's a globe. What are we going to call that thing?
Yeah.
Globy.
Oh.
Hey, there's a piece of talking floor. What should we call that?
Groundy?
You're not good at this.
There's a leaf blower. What do we call that?
Zach.
I cry.
Zach is on fire today.
Yeah.
Because of that Bears victory.
Yeah.
What Bears victory?
Yeah, 3-2 Park Cottage Grove and White Bear last night. 0.8 seconds left.
I tuned in. And
on the horn?
I did. Yep. That's my alma mater, and they were playing against the town I live in. Now, we live in the East Ridge boundary, but listening to Zach, he's fantastic at play-by-play. But because I listen to the show all the time, I'm always expecting, for instance, there was a too many men penalty, and there was confusion around it. The officials were conferring, and Zach must have said too many men like 900 times, and I'm like, come on, Zach, come on. Come on, it's right there for you, but he's a professional.
He's a professional.
Yeah, like during my speeches, I don't say anything greasy.
Yeah.
You got to separate the morning show between.
You got to keep it separated.
Hot cut. But hell of a job, Zach.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Hey, Zach, we got some listeners. Would you mind grabbing them?
Letting them in.
I thought I wasn't supposed to do that anymore.
Now do what you want.
Oh, yeah, grab them.
That's part of the experience of the Power Trip Morning Show.
Front page sports in a second. This is the Power Trip Morning Show on the Fan. Gonna show it tonight, yeah.
She got the way to miss Jared. She got the Fan.
That bass guitar. Go ahead, Neil Sedaka. Could have been me. Yeah, tell him. But it
was you. Neil Sedaka's got some old school rippers too, although some of them are creepy. The Sweet 16 one, greasy as hell.
Yeah. And he was 39. Yeah.
Basically an unregistered sex offender.
Yeah, this song kind of rocks. The woman
no good. Just the neighbor up the road who's like, come on. One more year.
Yeah.
One more year.
I'm bet nobody out there who had any idea this was Neil Sedaka.
I had no idea. No chance.
Bad blood. And it does sound like there's a goat singing with him.
Here, let's try it here.
Not a different one. And then you throw some flute in there. Can't you see Will Ferrell playing flute on this?
Yeah. Yaz flute.
Yeah. Yeah, Bad Blood. Like, Pantera needs to cover this.
But leave the flu. Time now for Front Page Sports, presented by Holiday Station Stores.
Holiday Station Stores. You can go to get Celsius energy drinks at Holiday. You can mix and match any 12-ounce Celsius or 16-ounce Celsius, and then if you buy two, you get one free.
Jeez, can't afford
not
to.
Yeah, not a bad deal at all. Plus, Holiday has an exclusive Celsius flavor. It's called Fruit Burst. Try it at Holiday today, and then maybe tomorrow. You could do it Sunday. I could maybe see you doing it Monday.
Do you want?
Possibly. No, not yet. I was busy.
Come on.
I'll catch up. All right, Kreese, let's go through this, shall we?
Yes.
It is a super wild card weekend. I give you the matchup. You tell me who you like and why.
Okay.
Tomorrow, Saturday, kicks off 3:30. First game's on NBC. Cleveland at the Houston Texans and their rookie head coach and their rookie quarterback.
I kind of like Houston. It's at home.
Same.
They're on a hot streak. Well, they're catching 2 points, I think.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
So that's, I don't know. I think the Cleveland magic is going to run out at some point, and Houston's confident and hot.
The second game tomorrow is the one everybody's complaining about because it's the Peacock exclusive. Miami at Kansas City. It's supposed to be ridiculously cold.
Yeah, Kansas City should handle business. I don't think they're going the distance. I don't think they'll make it to the Super Bowl. But Miami in the cold. I mean, Miami in weather under 50 degrees doesn't play well, especially Tua.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a tough one for him.
Yep, 4.5-point favorites.
I think, is Tyreek playing? Does anybody know?
Yeah. I think they'll all play.
That guy motivated might be a problem.
Yeah. Especially if he can get behind the defense.
Yeah. And Tua, man, I have more info on this than I probably should because I've been watching that show, Hard Knocks show.
Yeah.
Tua has the quickest release in the league. I think it's 2.4 seconds or something like that. It's incredible to watch that guy. If he can get the ball to Tyreek and Tyreek's as motivated as I think he's going to be, they might have a shot.
Yeah, I mean, a month ago, John, you know this as well, fantasy football-wise, they were unstoppable they have him and Waddle running just all streaks down the field.
And that running back had 18 touchdowns.
Yeah, and he's been out for, I think, 2 weeks.
Yeah.
They get that band together, but as Corey has said, you play this on, like, a neutral field, it would be a great game.
A neutral field, I like Miami.
Same, but the elements are going to be tough tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Pittsburgh at Buffalo, noon on Sunday. The Buffalo Bills are 9.5-point favorites on DraftKings.
Buffalo should win. I don't know if they will cover. That's a lot of points, especially in the playoffs.
And the weather is supposed to be terrible.
Yep. So, I mean, I would take the 10 points probably here.
The Dallas Cowboys are 7-point favorites as they host the Green Bay Packers 3:30 on Sunday.
And that line was 7.5 day before, so money coming in on Green Bay. I like Dallas a lot. Here, they're a force at home.
Same.
Green Bay. Yeah. I mean, the Vikings made them look like they were Super Bowl bound.
Yeah. I've said this all week, though. The Packers have nothing to lose. Nobody thought they'd be here. All the pressure's on Dallas.
Yeah. This is the playoffs, though.
Yeah, but Dallas is terrible in the playoffs.
They're good at home.
Yeah, but not in the playoffs.
You guys make great arguments.
Yeah, I don't like arguing with him.
The Lions. The Lions!
You love him.
I gotta stop.
Radio for five people.
Who am I gonna send that to?
But enough about what you're talking about.
Start sending it to somebody else.
Nope.
I should cut myself off.
Don't encourage.
You should cut your thang off.
Yeah.
On a webcam. What I would rather do.
Cut your thang off?
Or... The Lions host the Rams 7 o'clock. I have so many problems. 7 o'clock on Sunday. And the Lions on DraftKings are 3-point favorites.
I like the Rams here. Lions defense is hideous. I think the Rams are equipped to handle business. There should be a lot of scoring. Yeah, is it 50 and a half still or 51?
It is 51 and a half.
Ooh.
I'd take the over.
I still would take the over, yeah.
Oof, that's a lot of points.
I mean, track meet.
Do you want to bet it, Hawk?
No!
Mullins just shredded that defense with nothing to play for.
Man, I'd like a burrito with some shredded beef.
Oh.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
What do you put on your burritos?
Your dad's.
Jeez! My dad's what?
Special recipe.
Sour cream?
No.
Yuck.
Well, you said it.
I know.
Daisy Dukes.
The minute I did, I was repulsed.
My dad wears Daisy Dukes?
You're damn right he
does. If I tell him to. And make him stand out in the cold.
He's going to be 74 in a month.
Yeah. He's going to be... never mind.
The Eagles are going to Baker Mayfield and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers on Monday night at 7:15. The Eagles are 3-point favorites on the road. But, John, I think I just saw on SportsCenter they were showing a stat because the Eagles have lost 5 of their last 6 going into the postseason. And if I just saw that stat right, because I couldn't hear it, obviously, because I'm doing this show and I'm questioning life choices. I believe they said that there's 6 times in history that a team has made it to the postseason while losing 5 of their last 6 games, and it looked like that team has lost in the first round every time. So if I just read that stat right, it's basically if you free fall like this into the postseason, you lose in round 1.
Including the 97 Vikings.
All right.
There's 97 Vikings?
97 Vikings won,
your wish
though.
Came true, Zach.
Eddie Murray kicked a game-winning field goal at the end of that game. So
that Jake Reed with the long touch.
Yeah, they made a
big, the Giants?
Big comeback at the end of the game against the Giants, yes. I digress.
Good memory.
Yeah, thank you.
Good question.
Ask me what I did last week, though. No idea.
Oh, yeah, we watched some Brazzers.
Tampa Bay can't score. That's the problem.
Password, please.
And so this might be the get-well game for him because Philadelphia's defense is hideous. So if you give Baker any time, they're going to shred him. I mean, you can't cover Mike Evans alone. Then you add Chris Godwin. So it should be a good one. Should be some scoring because Philadelphia is going to score as well. But I don't know. I still think Philly will win and cover.
Yeah. Don't I have money on this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What side do you have?
See, now he's fully back. Yeah. He's back to gambling so much that already he's forgetting if he's making
bets.
Well,
I think I made 2 bets.
Yeah.
And I think this is one of them.
Yeah, I have Tampa +3. What's the other one? Oh, yeah. And I have Buffalo -10. Or do I?
Yeah, I think you do. Who do they play, Buffalo?
Pittsburgh.
That's right, yeah. Yeah, I just can't see Pittsburgh losing by more than 10.
I don't think Pittsburgh will get past the 50-yard line.
Well, that's good.
I'll take that bet.
You're vitamin deficient.
Sometimes both of you just uppercut me at the same time.
Dagger, uppercut.
Yeah, correct. Great. Oh, I just found a video he liked.
Yeah, speaking of Tiger, I heard you guys both kind of in passing reference yesterday that you have caught up on Fargo now.
Oh. Yeah.
One to go.
Yeah, man. I wish it went on forever.
So I need to watch this one.
Dude, it's the best.
It's the best.
It's been fun.
The best.
I still like the first one better than this one, but this is probably the second best.
I do not. This is my favorite now.
Really?
Yeah.
Man,
I didn't watch the second one. The first one I loved, and then I just fell off.
Holy.
Oh.
This one is definitely worth your time.
And it takes place in Minnesota.
Yeah.
All of them have, right?
Yep. Yeah.
So good, dude. The writing is incredibly, you should watch it. That's all. Download it and watch it.
And if you like movies, we can talk to Mr. Z in a second. He'll tell you what to watch and what not to watch.
That'd be sweet of him if you do that for me.
All right, Mr. Z next. This is the Power Trip Morning Show on the Fan.
The Power Hour starts at 8 a.m. It's at KFAN.com/watch, and it's powered by Quantum Fiber.
That's nice. Thank you, Quantum Fiber. We like you.
Big fan.
All right, should we talk film or what?
Well, hell yeah, man. Bop, bop, bop.
All right. Hi, Mr. Z.
Hey, guys. What's up?
What's happening, dude?
Nah, not mucho.
Yeah.
You know, just a bunch of dudes sitting around doing radio, pumped for a Mean Girls musical.
Mean Girls, well, yeah. We can get right into it. Yeah, I love Mean Girls musical this weekend. I'm a musical fan, so I'm proud. Maybe either the right or the wrong guy to talk about this movie.
The right guy. You're the right
cool.
one. Cool. Let's talk about it.
The floor is yours.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's really good. I always have to preface it by saying, like, if a person doesn't like musicals, there's really no, you know, there's no reviews you need to read. If you don't like musicals, don't bother. Mean Girls, as a reminder to people, isn't a remake of the Mean Girls musical. I mean, obviously it's based on it, but Mean Girls came out and then they made a musical on it. Tina Fey wrote Broadway musical, changed it up a little bit as you do for the stage, added a bunch of songs, and it was relatively successful. And they did a good job of translating that into a musical on screen, which is hard to do. Hmm. So yeah, it's got Renee Rapp as Regina George. It's very good.
Huh. Should I just see the original? Because I'm not going to like this one.
You haven't seen the original?
I've never seen the original.
Oh,
original
son Wales. Of a bitch.
Yeah, the original is the reason it's super successful is because the crossover. It wasn't a teenage girl movie. It was for everybody. And it's funny. And Tina Fey doesn't pull a lot of punches. These girls are real mean girls. And it's clever and funny. And of course, yeah, it's very good.
What if you just like teenage girl movies?
Ooh. Yeah, well, I don't know. I'm not sure. Then I guess go for it.
Yeah, just go for it, man.
I
what
just
are you
like
gonna
that.
Do?
Ooh,
you gotta go for it.
Ooh,
wasn't sure.
What else is coming out? Is there anything else?
One
worth
of the
seeing?
Greatest movies of all time, Beekeeper.
Beekeeper. Oh, I forgot about Beekeeper. I didn't forget about Beekeeper. We've been kind of concentrating on Mean Girls. Yes, Beekeeper comes out this week. They've been throwing a lot of money at advertising that movie. So Mean Girls is going to be number one. Beekeeper should be a distant number two. And then it gets kind of quiet. Originally, after the writer's strike was finally ended, it wasn't too disruptive, and I thought we were going to be fine. And then the actors decided they needed more. They took another 7 weeks to solve their problem, and so we lost a lot of movies. So really, the next movie is Argyle in February.
Have you seen I know you told me on text that you haven't seen Poor Things. I would encourage you to see that. Have you seen American Fiction?
No, similar thing, although I can't wait. A lot of these movies, what happens, is that they know what they're, when it comes out, they know they have like an Oscar Golden Globe thing. And so they'll release it limited into, major markets. And then they wait, they get the buzz. And so in mid-January, we're going to start seeing American Fiction and, Poor Things expand into every market. But because I missed it. Yeah.
Yeah. But that's the reason I asked about that is because Max is raving about it and it's finally in the theater here by the radio station today. So I might go see it tonight. I'm looking forward to seeing that. I hear good things about it. And what was the other one I was going to ask you about? Darn it. I was going to tell you about The Beekeeper. The reason that I'm interested in it, because number one, Jason Statham's a stud, and I like to see guys who raise bees kill people. And also, it's only an hour and 45 minutes long. And that's a real rarity these days, man.
Yeah. Wouldn't you guys love to sit in on a meeting between Statham and his agent?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And just their plan? Because it has to be, as long as there's guns and car crashes and chases.
I mean, he's Van Damme.
But what am I doing?
How dare you?
You're a beekeeper. Yeah, I'll be a beekeeper. I don't care. Whatever.
Yeah.
Wasn't he in Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels?
Yeah, he was the main dude.
He used to be kind of like a...
And Snatch. Seriously.
Yeah, I'm sure at some point.
No doubt. He's Statham.
He was in Snatch.
Yeah, he was.
He was.
And...
Singular?
He's in Meg 2.
And Meg 1.
Yeah, a masterpiece.
he was in Snatch.
That movie.
Yeah.
That was a good movie, by the way.
Damn right.
People forget about Brad. People forget about Brad Pitt's Snatch.
Yeah, he was in... He's
not Tommy.
Yeah. Anyway, good stuff.
All right. Anything else, Mr. Z, worth discussing?
No, unfortunately not. We'll be good for a while. But yeah, it's going to be back. I mean, the movies are the studios finally made announcements. 25 and 26 are going to be two of the biggest release years we've remembered. But 24 is going to be kind of quiet.
Well, crap. Thanks, dude.
Yep.
No, wait, hold on.
All right, guys, talk to you later.
Wait.
Zach, say something good.
As we stand here, Oppenheimer still in some theaters. And I just was wondering, is that like going to be a normal thing in this year now with the lack of movies? Are we going to start seeing more older movies go back into theaters to allow people to catch up on maybe if they missed it?
Yeah, a little bit. Disney's doing that with three of their movies that they went straight to video with. The other thing is on a movie like Oppenheimer, you'll see that come back. One is sometimes the studio's trying to hit a magic number. They have percents, and so if they get past, like, if they've had a deal where if they get to $120 million, they get this instead of that. And mm-hmm. so sometimes they'll bring it back just to try to get their numbers up. And other times is that whenever around the Oscars, you'll always see a re-release. So, but yes, at 24, we will see, I think, Luca, Turning Red, and Soul. In fact, Soul's this weekend are all coming out theatrically from Disney.
Cool. Hmm. All good movies, by the way. Hmm. I like all those. All right. Thanks, Mr. Z.
Thank you.
Cool Breeze.
Ah. You say Cool Breeze?
He did, yes. He said Cool Breeze.
Yeah, he's from the 70s.
Is he drinking?
Sure he is.
He's in Meg 2.
Okay. I'm sorry.
But he is, though. It's an unadiable.
It's so good. How good is that film, Hawk?
It's better than good. Yeah. Asking a question like that is dumb because it's so good.
Say no to.
I can tell you one thing.
Careful. Yeah. Snatch.
Oh, no,
he
didn't.
Yes to he said
no,
he did.
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
How about on Rotten Tomatoes? Mean Girls 70, Beekeeper 71.
I'm telling you, man, those movies are always good. Like you said, I know you were joking, but it's true. All they do is they take the same script and change what he does for a living.
Yeah, you're going to
see
that.
He's in a movie called The Factory Worker.
Yep.
He's in a movie called The Guy at the Donuts Place.
The guy, you mean the bakery?
No, they don't make anything else. Just donuts, bitch.
God, you're dumb.
Yeah.
Me?
How do you not know the difference between a guy at a donut shop and a bakery?
Is a Krispy Kreme a bakery, technically?
Don't ask questions.
Yeah, a couple of idiots asking about donuts.
Yeah. Y'all snatch more. I'm sorry.
Snatch more.
Snatch more.
What do you need me to do that for?
Are we all high? Is there mattress leaking into the studio?
High on life.
Yeah.
I keep seeing those radon ads again, man.
Yeah.
Is it bad?
I have no idea.
Radon.
Like the more radon combat guy? No, like the gas.
No, that's radon.
Radon. Yeah. That's a different game, Hawk.
Shucks that sharp-ass hat.
Oh, yeah. Raiden wails.
He does.
Yeah, Raiden was one of my guys for sure.
Like, mm-hmm.
Liu Kang.
The panty drawer.
Hawk, who's your go-to in Mortal Kombat?
Oh. I was Scorpion guy.
Sub-Zero. Yeah. I'm a Sub-Zero.
Yeah, I like
Sub-Zero
Scorpion. Too.
So is Tommy. Hawkey was the panty guy.
Well played.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's the panty guy.
That was me.
Yep.
That's what I did. That was my special power.
But only if Sub-Zero's a dude.
Yes.
Yeah. What? That was your special
You want to fight? Well, let me put on these panties.
More of a Dom Zero guy.
What?
Sorry.
Oh, jeez.
Brilliant.
Weird.
Super.
Zach, your mic's on.
I got real. Yeah.
His mic's on.
You can tell it's a Friday. We've officially derailed.
Hey, guys, we'll let Nordo know he's got a live spot in a minute.
Nordo?
Yeah.
Power Trip Morning Show on the Fan.
Gaze at a graveyard. So I suppose we should probably start doing this, right? We only have like 2 weeks. We got to start giving away tickets to Initials Game 500.
If you're waiting for permission, you have permission.
Okay. Let's do it. 1-800-320-5326, caller 11. We are going to have the Initials Game 500 right here in the KFAN press box. Big celebration. And we want you to join us. So give us a call and good luck.
The mighty, mighty Deftones. One of my five favorite bands of all time. Shall we do What Really Matters?
Yes.
I say this all the time. There's Corey Cohen. This is one of the few songs.
Yeah.
In the world that I love that I don't know the words to.
That's, I think every time we talk about this, I say that's the beauty of the Deftones is, like you just said, they're one of my five favorite bands of all time. I know every word of this song, But there's a lot of their songs that I don't. That was I Dressed You in Her Clothes.
Ooh.
So Drive Me Far. Not a lot of words in this song either.
Yeah, it doesn't even matter. Like, nope, you can hear whatever he's singing about.
Exactly.
It hurts a little
just
bit.
Just in the ether, yep.
Yeah.
They're so good.
Yeah, I like this a lot.
And you like the little stuff in music, so you like that little breath that he takes right before the guitar kicks in.
I love that they didn't edit it out. There's a Steve Miller song that's like that, man. They left all his breaths in, and it's my favorite part of the song. I'm weird that way, but I love that stuff.
That's what really matters.
I know.
Right?
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Did you guys see the old Thunder Blazers game last night?
The Thunder down under last night.
The Thunder won by 62. And the Blazers were 55-point dogs. They didn't even cover. Plus 55. Can we just close up the Portland Trail Blazers now that Dame's gone? Can we contract them?
I mean,
we should.
It's over for Portland.
Are they no longer Blazing Trails?
I know you're joking, but at one point, I think it was Bet Online or one of these websites, live bet, you could bet the Blazers at plus 60.
Yeah, sure. I bet before the game they were 10 point
I think
dogs.
They were 13.
13?
Yeah.
Yeah. Jeez, 62-point win.
Just running up the score.
Isn't the guy we all wanted, Scoot Henderson, didn't he have the worst plus-minus in NBA history?
Oh, I don't know.
I think yesterday he had the worst plus-minus in NBA history. I think it was like minus 55. Hold on. Hang on.
We don't have time for this.
We don't have time for this. Ain't nobody got time for this.
Nobody cares about this.
Yeah, minus 56 in 31 minutes.
That's the worst. Nobody cares about this except for Max, and Max isn't here. But, you know, when a team bottoms out and just accumulates draft picks,
second lowest.
You almost always have to wait for all of those draft picks to come to fruition for you to, like, ascend to the top. OKC's already there with Josh Giddey, SGA, Chet Holmgren. They already are there. And they have 7 or 8 first-rounders in the next, like, 4 years.
Yeah.
So, like, the, quote, process for Philadelphia, OKC somehow has done it even better. They're one of the four or five best teams in the league, and they are low. They're the opposite of the Wolves. Right? We had to give away everything to get where we are.
Yeah.
And it's working. We'll see if it holds. They did the opposite. They got there on their own by just drafting well and now have so much equity the next 4 or 5 years. This team's going to be a problem for a long time.
And SGA is a top
10,
maybe 7 in the NBA.
Yep.
Chet Holmgren is going to be your rookie of the year. And Giddey, you know, the off.
And we'll see if that bites him or not.
Right.
What really matters, though, is this
space.
The final frontier.
Yeah. Smells like a combination of diesel fuel and barbecue, according to the astronauts that have been up there.
Two of my favorite things.
That's what I'm saying.
Go to space.
The smell is caused by dying stars. Like Michael Hutchins.
David Carradine. Betty White. Pee Wee.
Why I had to say Michael
Did they
Hutchins.
Go out the same way?
They did.
No.
Betty White went out that way?
Yeah. Oh, my God. I almost just said it.
All right.
Jeez. I almost just said she was a chronic you-know-what. Almost.
Does that work on women?
Sad.
Correct. It's a serious question.
Yeah, why would it not?
What do you care?
I don't know. It's just because you don't...
Why mind your own business?
You never hear women doing that.
How do you know? I'm sure it happens, right?
Man, I don't know. Let me check.
Call Tommy.
Do women...
Oh.
Yeah. At work?
What's that called?
Autoerotic.
Yeah.
I mean...
I like how most of this room is asking whether or not women are into autoerotic asphyxiation. The way that Sauce worded it, I thought Sauce was going to Google, do women have orgasms? I've heard they do.
It does happen.
I think it works.
It's very rare, but apparently it does.
Really?
Happen. Yeah.
And then does it say, according to the power trip, see Betty White?
couldn't keep her hands off herself.
Yeah, you got to have a spotter.
Yeah, American treasure.
Come on, ladies.
Yeah, man.
Gable Steveson is that how you say it? Steveson? Steveson?
I think
no
idea.
The wrestler?
Yeah.
I think that's right.
Steveson?
Yeah, Steveson, maybe. He's there's no huge. N. Everybody wants to say Stevenson, but there's no N in the middle. Anyway, he is not going to wrestle for the U. The WWE has basically said, how about you just focus on your pro career and let's wrap this whole collegiate thing up. So I think the Gophers were pretty pumped to have him back, but now he's not going to wrestle for the Gophers.
Not going to need that degree.
I understand.
You don't need it. You'll be fine.
Set yourself free.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Dude's a beast. What really matters, though, is this.
Mini oranges are green when they're ripe. Scientists remove their chlorophyll to make them more appealing to North American consumers.
Do it, sauce.
Chloroform, more like boriform.
Wow, you botched it.
But isn't that the line?
No.
All right, tell me, Steven Spielberg, what the line is.
You said chloroform.
Isn't that what he said, though?
That's a...
Oh, boy.
That's a different...
Portland, wait, we just said... It's okay. We just said Portland should be contracted. Portland at Minnesota tonight. The Timberwolves hosting the Portland Trail Blazers at 7 o'clock. The voice of the Wolves will be here in like an hour. Alan Horton.
Wolves 14 and a half.
Yikes.
Yeah.
What's the over-under on Anthony Edwards' turnovers in the final minutes of the game?
Or dribbling the ball like somebody playing a video game for the first
Ridiculous.
Time.
Yeah, like my friend who had his arms blown off in the war.
Rosie.
Would have less turnovers than he had in the stretch.
I'll take that bet. anyway, Marnie Gellner will be here in a little bit as well, and Alan Horton. Wolves radio play-by-play guy. You can hear him on The Fan and always on that Timberwolves station, channel, whatever, on the iHeartRadio app. 24 hours a day,
Wolves search channel. Minnesota Timberwolves on
iHeartRadio.
Hawks
always listening to it.
Always.
I can't stop.
What
I
really
have a
matters?
Headphone, one in my ear right now, listening to it just in my
It's always ear. In stereo.
What are they talking about?
Dealing with disruption.
Mm-hmm. Oh. He's right. What really matters is this.
The chills.
They're multiplying.
Brilliant.
If you listen to music and you get the chills, that's because you're enjoying it so much, your brain is releasing dopamine.
Wow.
How about that?
Is that right?
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
And neat.
Yeah.
I've had that at concerts, yeah.
Yeah, I sometimes don't know.
Thought it was when you had to take a deuce.
Sometimes I get the chills then, too, because I know what's about to happen.
Hawk's dad for sure does.
What's about to go down.
Yeah, he's so excited.
So much dopamine.
Yeah, I can't wait.
The brain's fascinating. You know, I need some kind of a scientist to come up with a way to trick my brain into thinking that everything tastes like Raising Cane's so I can actually eat healthy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Can't they just rewire it or pump me full of drugs that make my brain think that I'm processing food differently?
Have you ever gotten just super stoned? In your life, like just super, like hardcore baked.
I've been stoned so infrequently that I don't know on the Richter scale where I rank.
Yeah, let's get you up to like a 9.5.
Yeah, where you start,
and then that starts, you know, seeing what you like,
and you start eating mixing bowl size bowls of cereal.
Yes,
yeah.
But I would eat that now.
Like a, and then you mix them together like Lucky Charms.
Oh, I did that sounds once great. I don't think I'm going to get high and have a steak.
You get high.
I don't think I'm going to do that.
I walked to the store and got two things of icing.
Yeah.
See, that's what I would do.
Did you eat all of them?
But that's something I eat anyway.
No, I ate most of one.
Oh, so
I feel like that sugar
would get you.
I got real sick. Yeah.
I feel like in the past year, basically right after I turned 40, if I had a snack, if it was like hot and spicy Cheez-Its or chips or something near bedtime, stomach ache deluxe. I used to be able to eat whatever the hell I want. No big deal. Stomach aches now. What the hell? So I couldn't imagine icing would
That's rich.
Do rich.
Yeah, but the cannabis kind of calms your stomach down a bit.
Does it?
It really does. I never usually have a stomach ache on.
Does it calm your hoots down too?
No.
Wow.
The opposite.
He wasn't lying there.
No. It sounded like he was slowing a horse.
Whoa. Easy, girl.
The last couple of times I've been to Costco, I have noticed that they are now selling, maybe they've been selling it for a long time, but I've never seen it. Just giant tubs, of course, because it's Costco, of cookie dough.
Wasn't that your nickname in high school, Sus?
Oh.
Yeah.
Giant tubs, man.
Poor sauce.
Four giant tubs.
You got to be careful with
GTs.
Those.
GTs.
I think if I got stoned to the 9.5 Richter scale, whatever you were talking about, I think that's where I would go. I would walk to Costco and get that giant thing of cookie dough.
Mm-hmm.
That man. Sounds really good.
I'd love to see you do it.
Churro.
I love this. You know what you do? You go to Costco, you get that cookie dough, and you go, you look at it as you're leaving, you go, pizza. I'm high. I wonder if that tastes good.
That pizza there.
No chance.
Bangs. I love that.
There is, first of all, it's not no chance.
It's so close to zero. It's a virtual zero.
I'm telling you, get just ripped.
Is it, do you not like the sauce?
Never had it, never will.
He hates sauce.
Yeah. It's very clear.
Yeah.
What? Clear.
Oh.
With an L.
Are you high?
Go for basketball and our buddy Ben Johnson taking on the Indiana Hoosiers tonight.
Let's go, guys.
Yeah. Yes.
That'll be great.
Man.
Big sports night.
It's fun to see him winning.
Yes,
you know?
Is. Yes, it is.
That'll be on AM 1130, 103.5 FM.
Is that right?
Yep.
Zacho, you're too young to remember when the Gopher basketball team kicked ass.
It never happened.
No, I remember Wally Szczerbiak and Latrell Sprewell.
Wow.
Sam Cassell. Kevin Garnett.
90s Gopher basketball kicked ass.
Okay, I don't remember that.
That 97 team was sick.
But of course you remember Wally Szczerbiak.
But it got taken away because they didn't do their homework.
Well, but it comes full circle because now the Gopher football team got into a bowl game because of their homework. Fantastic.
Right.
Look at the academics of the University of Minnesota.
Which is good. That's important.
Dear God.
Not really.
No.
What really matters is this.
It's not.
Okay. The oldest house in New York, New York City, is a cottage in Queens near LaGuardia Airport. It was built in 1654 by the Rikers family. Yeah, the Rikers Island prison family. And even has a family cemetery in its backyard.
Jeez.
1654. Which in the great scheme of things, you can stay at hotels made that long ago in England, you know. But for America, that's pretty old.
Speaking of England, so yesterday it was officially announced that the Vikings are going back to London.
Yes.
And oh, good for us. We've known that for, what, a couple of months?
Yeah. Maybe
2 months or so. So we've been behind the scenes kind of scamming and scheming. How do we get there as quickly as possible?
Guy.
Right. So we're, you know, the power trip's going to London in the fall. Well, then I go into Chad Abbott's office yesterday. And he's like, well, you're not going. I'm like, oh, yeah, I am. He goes, oh, no, you're not. I'm like, oh, yes, I am. He's like, oh, try me. And I'm like, oh, I will. So we had that little debate, that little showdown. That was fun. He tried to pretend he was boss for a second. That was adorable. But then I also heard, Barrero and Guernsey talking about how, well, power trip, I'm sure they're going to get to go. How come we don't get to go? And then they joked about doing a fan flip, right, where maybe they go and we stay. No, we're going. If they want to go, they can figure out their own way to go. We're going.
What time would their show be on over there?
That's a good point.
Is it 5 hours?
9 o'clock?
Is it 6 hours later? Six?
Six, yeah.
I think it's six, yeah. So, yeah.
So 9 to 12:30.
Have at it.
Actually, that would be fun. We come back.
Yeah, just go for it.
We come back in the evening and get hammering.
So it'll be like the top 11 at 11.
Let's go.
There you go.
Did you guys hear?
Good one.
What's the college football coach? What's his name?
PJ Fleck?
No.
Nick Saban.
The Lanning
Pete
guy?
Pete Sauce's buddy. Pete Sauce's buddy.
Glenn Mason.
Yeah. Oh, there you go.
Mason was on for an hour yesterday.
Fantastic.
He's the best.
I was driving back from the Six Lot. I heard the whole thing. It was great. His stories were fantastic. I've never met the man. I hope he's a good dude. I love listening to him.
He's a great dude.
But I loved it the most when he told Dan one time, because Dan interrupted him. He goes, be quiet. Like, oh, that was the best.
That's how I felt when Abbott was telling me I wasn't going to London. I believe I actually did the hand gesture where you just kind of...
It really was something to watch. Like, you're not exaggerating. You're not like... It was like, I don't know, a couple of like, what is it, turkeys just starting to spar?
Yeah, you know how turkeys spar?
Yeah,
turkeys are always fighting.
That's a reference everyone that's listening will clearly understand. Turkeys sparring.
Turkey fights.
You know how they kind of puff out their wings?
Yeah, they
like
circle each other.
Yeah,
and then
a good old-fashioned...
Like bird
spar.
Bird fight.
Bird fight.
Right, Zach?
I've completely lost my mind in this segment.
You're high.
This segment?
Yeah. I wasn't making a joke with the Sprewell thing. I thought you were talking about the Wolves until you started talking about
none
Omar.
Of us got that joke.
No.
We all thought
it wasn't a joke. My mind is nuts.
Well, so you're 9.5.
Getting high
all the time
and
walking
in
the traffic.
Correct. Those are always on your mind.
Yeah, like Wayne Newton said.
No, I think it was Willie Nelson. Yeah. Wayne Newton.
It's the most Friday show we've ever had, I think.
With a large audience, too. Yeah. They're going to go back and go, what the hell?
Yeah, right. I think we get community service for this.
Right, even worse in person. That's why when everybody shows up on Fridays, I always say, lower your expectations.
Yeah.
It's worse than you think. If you like the show, prepare to be disappointed when you see the man behind the curtain. Go ahead, somebody do it.
I love the man behind
okay,
the curtain.
Okay, yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Hawks never found him.
No, it's Paul Allen.
I believe you have been confused with the man behind the stall.
Oh, he doesn't make it there, though.
Yeah. Well, unless Hawks taking a dump, he makes it there.
That's true.
Is it my turn or your turn?
I think it's mine.
What really matters is this.
The Waldorf Astoria Hotel in New York City once had its own private railroad track at Grand Central so that its guests could clandestinely enter and exit New York City. Largely abandoned now, it only operates when the president is in town in case there's a need for an emergency exit.
Hmm. Oh, wow.
Yeah, interesting.
Yeah.
Sounds like a good route for a heist.
Man, back in the day when you were rich, you were super rich, man. I guess you are now too, I guess. But you get my point. Like,
right.
Like those guys, the oil barons and stuff like that. Like, talk about have and have not. Jeez Louise.
Right, but I think your point is back then to be that crazy rich, yeah. There were about three people that were in that group.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Now there's just so many crazy rich people. But back in the day, when you got to that level.
It was like being a god.
You could do whatever you wanted. Kind of like now, but I know what you mean. I understand the difference. A lot of fun.
Yeah, it's fun. Man. I bet it was fun to be rich.
Yeah, we should try to be rich now.
I don't need it.
What?
Why? Nah, I don't need it, man. What am I going to do with all that money?
Yeah, what is he going to do with all that money?
The casino?
Yeah.
Give it back, though. Yeah, he does it now.
What the hell, man?
All right.
I mean, the chips would be different colors, but who cares? Same game.
Yeah, I got dip.
Whoa. Whoa. God. Almost broke through the wall Kool-Aid Man style.
What did you think I said?
It was going to end with a couple of Z's.
It usually does.
I mean, well played, Zach.
Well done.
By the way, I don't know how often I type word out. Is it two Z's or one?
It's two.
I was going to say, I think it's two, but I think the more the merrier. You typed that word.
This morning.
When I was texting Lawyer Lambert this morning.
You were texting Tommy?
Yeah.
Asking how his day went?
Yep.
I was like, okay. Dear Lawyer Lambert, I might need your services. This morning I accidentally...
Why are you texting him?
Because it's his lawyer.
He's my lawyer.
Oh.
That was the whole I might need your services part.
Yeah,
That's what you call it.
Man.
I love it. Well, that time I made the joke on Twitter about legal trouble in Vegas, joking, your dad immediately called me. He's like, everything good? I'm not barred there. Or I'm not licensed there, but I know people that are. What do you? And I was like, no, it was a joke.
Yeah.
He's like, oh.
He's good about that.
Oh, for sure.
Your dad's got a great laugh.
Just in case I was in the joint.
Yeah, he'd come get you.
Oh,
yeah.
For sure.
Oh, yeah.
Man, the joint.
Yeah.
It's a great name for it. Makes it sound actually kind of fun.
It'd be a bad place to be, though.
He'd leave for me for a while, but he'd come get you guys.
He would.
Oh, yeah.
Because you still have to learn a lesson.
Oh, yeah. Plus, you like that jailhouse sex.
No holds barred, just...
Yeah, Dad, don't worry about it. I'm having the time of my life here.
Would you quit going to jail?
They're using me as a pin cushion. Wow. I'm going to go get the pizza.
I was playing cards next to a guy a couple weeks ago that said he did 30 days in jail. And I hadn't thought of this. He said the worst part about the 30 days he spent in jail were the lights stay on overnight and the drug addicts just scream 24 hours a day.
Is he sure it's the drug addicts or is someone getting the boots thrown to him?
He said it was definitely just going through withdrawal and they just scream at all hours of the night. He's like, you just never can sleep because the lights are on and they're screaming. That sounds hideous. I'm going to avoid jail, and that's why I haven't executed my heist yet. It's not perfect.
It's not difficult to stay out of jail. Perfect.
Oh, God. That
hasn't been too difficult.
But it's difficult to stay out of jail when you're going to rob banks, and I'm going to. I just haven't executed the plan yet.
Hmm. You think there's a dude in the Twin Cities named Rob Banks?
Yeah.
Robert Banks, probably.
Adam's father.
We're going live to Hennepin County Jail right now.
Guys tweaking out, man.
Go to sleep, Pete. You love that jailhouse sex.
Come on, there's your podcast title.
Jailhouse sex?
Yeah. It's also at one point going to be Hawk's book.
I'm writing a book?
It's a picture book.
Zach.
Yeah, whatever.
You guys know we have 2 hours left. We got a long way to go. Parrish should be here shortly. Marnie Gellner will be here in a little bit. Alan Horton in a little bit as well, making his initials game debut. And speaking of initials,
Pete.
Listen up, Pete. At 8:15, $56,500 on the line for the St. Paul Federal Credit Union initials jackpot. Yeah, one of you listeners is going to get a crack at that. $56,500, Zach.
And speaking of the 500 part you just said there, really sloppy transition. But on Twitter, at KFAN1003, you follow us on Twitter/X. Use hashtag PowerTrip. Comment your 5 guesses at today's initials. And a winner will be randomly selected to join us in Initials Game 500. So get the guesses in there if you want to see us in a couple of weeks.
Nailed it. All right. More of the PowerTrip Morning Show after this with John Kriesel on The Fan. The Fan.